can't count money, but I've been counting every mile for a month of Sunday. Whatever road, however long, I've got wheels, I'm rolling on.
One of the lessons I learned that no one tells you about when you're in a chair is your ankles are not really going to hold out like they did before. So I don't even know when or how I completely tore all the tendons and ligaments in one of my ankles and had to get it fixed surgically. And then ever since then, I now wear ankle braces every day in order to give my ankles a little more stabilization. I don't have to wear them if I'm not standing or riding. I can go without them then, but if I'm planning on doing either of those things, they have to have a little bit of help.
How does this thing go on here?
I don't know, that's why I called you.
Everyone meet Frank. This is Frank. He helps clean my house because if I have to vacuum, it's like a 45-minute process, and my house is not that big. Because every time I have to vacuum, you know, I have to set my brakes, vacuum everything I can reach right here, undo my brakes, move to a new spot, and do that again. So, of course, that takes a very long time. So I have Frank that helps me vacuum my house. One of the coolest parts about my house is my drop down shelves. So I'm in charge of feeding in the morning, which I love. I love that I built my place to do that. That was my whole goal. So I feed everything, check everything, grain. Take my time too. I mean, I don't really come out and just feed in 5 minutes and go back inside. Like, I make it a 30-minute process out here. It's crazy how the simple stuff becomes some of your favorite stuff. So, like carrying grain bags, it's one of the only things that I can still do by myself with my horses. So I am kind of stubborn and always want to do it because I can, and I feel like it makes it possible for me to still take care of them. So I always have work to do since I am self-employed and a speaker. Then I always have emails to answer, something to do with that. I have a standing frame inside my house, so I try to stand for a couple hours every day. So my standing frame makes it possible for me to stand every day. You can see I can transfer over to it. I can put my feet in the little sections on the bottom. It locks my knees out for me and then stabilizes my butt and my hips in order to push me up to standing. Super good for the mental part, the physical aspect. I mean, all of it for me to be able to stand up every day, of course, because I'm sitting all the time. So I see the world now down low, and it's also part of my body that it doesn't ever get to stand up and stretch out. So by standing every day for an hour or two, it just stretches everything that needs to stretch. It gives some strength to my bones, being weight bearing on them. Plus being able to go back and forth with my legs just shifts the way that the weight is on my bones, which is also really helpful.
Sister, as a happy horse, is always a better performing horse. And I believe that if she's healthy from the inside out, she's going to be able to perform at her best. She definitely feels good when she is healthy. She, you know, wakes up and enjoys her day, and therefore I know she's going to be a happy horse and be able to perform when I ask her to.
Dear Amberlee, I'm a huge fan of your story. The year of your crash, that was the same year I was born. I wish that I could meet you, but I'm in Texas and you're in Utah. And also, I wish I could meet Tate. My birthday is August 27th. I love in the movie how you didn't give up when you thought everything was lost. Please write back. Your fan, Alexis.
Something else I get asked a lot about is, what are the chances of me walking again? Or what am I doing in that aspect? Or what have they told me? And when I was in my accident, they put me as a complete injury to start with. They said I had no chance of regaining anything below T11, T12 again. It was 2 days after surgery that my mom was in my hospital room and she put a hand over on my leg and I felt it. So 2 days after that, they moved me to an incomplete injury, which means that, you know, you're not complete, your spinal cord is not severed, which it was never severed, but they figured with the intensity of the injury that that's what I would be. Well, then, of course, miracles, you know, continue to happen. And I've been able to regain sensation to my knees. Not perfect and not everywhere, but at least it makes me be able to feel more than what they thought. Originally, it was from my waist down, there was absolutely nothing, and now I have some sensation that comes through in different parts on my legs.
And then we'll go half rope climb after each round.
CrossFit seems insane and kind of crazy. I wasn't sure how it was gonna go. I have never worked out in my life. I didn't even take PE in high school. So obviously I was getting into a very different depth, something that I had never been in before. But it has been awesome to work with Kyle and really learn what I'm capable of and honestly feel myself even get stronger.
So my friend Emmy, her horse stays here and she has been my best friend. Like, we went to college together and I brought her to the dark side of barrel racing, right? So I introduced her to barrel racing, so we have her barrel horse and she comes and rides every day. We ride horses, bathe horses, feed, clean stalls. Have to figure out what I'm making for dinner for everyone every day. So whether I've got to set out or prep that or make that plan.
One of the things that meant the most to me was that I could feel comfortable in my own house. And it was really cool when I came across this house because it was already built. And the only thing I really had to change was a couple handles in the bathroom. Of course, putting down my cabinet so that I could reach them and the ramps to get in. But otherwise, I'm able to reach everything in this house. And that has really been important to me to be independent.
That's my life every day. Every day is different, but it's never dull.